Today we are going to study the numericals based on gas laws. You must have gone through the theory part. So today we are going to study the numericals. So we have to study two laws on which these numericals are based. That is Boyle's law and Charles' law. Thereafter we have to study one more law, which is a mixture of all these two laws. So Boyle's law. So what does Boyle's law state? Boyle's law states that temperature remaining constant, the volume is inversely proportional to pressure. That is P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Then what is Charles' law? Charles' law states that pressure remaining constant, volume is directly proportional to temperature. That is V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. So quickly we'll write them down first. Okay. First is Boyle's law. Here temperature is constant. Okay, so temperature is constant, volume is inversely proportional to pressure. That is P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Second is Charles' law. Now in Charles' law, the pressure is constant. That is, volume is directly proportional to the temperature. That is, V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. Okay, now third one is based on both these laws. That is called as gas equation. P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. So you know that after studying the theory, the pressure, temperature, volume, they are interrelated. So Boyle's B comes before C. So Boyle's law comes before Charles' law. In Boyle's law, the temperature is constant. Remember that. And in Charles' law, pressure is constant. In Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. And in Charles' law, V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. And then the gas laws, that is the mixture of these two laws, that is P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Apart from that, you have to always take the temperature in Kelvin. Okay. So how do you convert degree Celsius to Kelvin? That is the important thing we need to know. Okay. So if you want to convert degree Celsius to Kelvin, you have to multiply it by 273. And you have to also remember atmospheric pressure. One atmospheric pressure is equal to 760 millimeter of mercury. Some of them they take 76 centimeter also. That also right. So whenever you are studying sums, we have to come across degree Celsius and you have to convert it into Kelvin to use these formulas. And whenever atmospheric pressure 760 millimeter or 76 centimeter, you have to use. And you know 1 liter is 1000 cc, that is centimeter cube. Okay, so you need to know all these points, this laws, before we get started with the numericals. So please quickly write these laws down, learn them before we get started. Alright? Okay. Now we are going to start with the numericals. Now the numericals are taken from Simplified Chemistry by Viraf Dalal. Now these numericals, the sums are really very good and they are very helpful for you for your exams. So I suggest you go through all the numericals from there. So we'll start with the first numerical. Now before we go for the first numerical, just few minutes back I had said that whenever you have to convert degree Celsius to Kelvin, you have to add 273, not multiply. Remember that. If you want to convert degree Celsius to Kelvin, you have to add 273 to it. Okay, and vice versa. If you want to convert Kelvin to degree Celsius, you have to subtract minus 273, not multiply. That's the correction. Okay. Now regarding the first sum, let's start with the first sum and see how we have to solve the sums. So first sum, what volume will a gas occupy at 740 millimeter pressure, which at 1480 millimeter occupies 500 cc, temperature being constant? So if temperature being constant, then it's supposed to be the Boyle's law. Okay, so let's first quickly write down all the particulars. So over here, they are asking what volume. So V1 you have to find out. Then 740 millimeter pressure. So P1, 740 millimeter. Which at 1480 millimeter occupies 500 cc. So volume over here on the other side you write down. 500 cc and pressure P2 you write down 1480 millimeter. Alright, so now since temperature is constant, so we have to use the Boyle's law. So write it down. According to Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Substitute that. 740 into V1 is equal to 1480 into 500. So V1 will be 1480 into 500 upon 740. So that comes to 1000 cc. That's how the first sum is done. Now we'll do the second sum. The volume of a given mass of a gas at 27 degrees Celsius is 100 cc. To what temperature should it be heated at the same pressure so that it will occupy a volume of 150 cc? So over here they have said that they have given the temperature, that is 27 degrees Celsius, and they have given the volume. They have not given the pressure. So pressure is constant. So if a pressure is constant, then it's supposed to be Charles' law. Okay, so quickly first we'll write down all the particulars, then we'll use the Charles' law. So the volume of a given mass of a gas is 27. Sorry, the temperature of volume is 100 cc and temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. So see, the temperature T1 is 27 degrees Celsius. Now whenever you are working it out, you need it in Kelvin. Okay, so 27 degrees Celsius, how do you convert it into Kelvin? Add 273 to it. So 27 plus 273, that is equal to 300 Kelvin. Then they have given the volume. V1 as 100 cc and on the other side the temperature is to be found out, T2, so take it as x or T also. We can take T or x. Volume is given 150 cc. So use the formula. V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. Substitute the values. 100 upon 300 is equal to 150 upon x. So these two zeros get cancelled. Therefore, x is equal to 300 Kelvin. Now, the temperature is in Kelvin. You have to convert it into degree Celsius. So how do you convert it? You have to again subtract 273 to it. So 300 minus 273, that is 177 degree Celsius. So if you are getting the answer, whenever you are working, you have to convert it into Kelvin. And then whenever you have to write the answer, you can bring it back to degree Celsius by subtracting 273 to it. Okay, so now we go on the third sum. A fixed mass of a gas has a volume 750 cc at minus 23 degrees Celsius and 800 millimeter pressure. So they have given the temperature, pressure and volume also. So calculate the pressure for which its volume will be 720 cc, the temperature being minus 3 degrees Celsius. So quickly we'll write down the particulars. This is your third sum. So a fixed mass of a gas has a volume 750 cc. So take this as V1, 750 cc. Then temperature they have given minus 23 degrees Celsius. So minus 23 plus 273 I'm going to add. So it comes to 250 Kelvin. Then pressure they have given 800 millimeter. So P1 800 millimeter. And on the other side, the volume is given as 720 cc and temperature is given as minus 3 degree Celsius. If you add 273 to it, so it comes to 270 Kelvin. And the pressure we have to find out, P2. So use the formula P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon P2. Substitute the values. So 800 into 750 upon 250 is equal to P2 into 720 upon 270. So P2 will be 800 into 750 into 270 upon 250 into 720. This both when you send on the other side becomes reciprocal. So when you work this out, it comes to 900 millimeter. Okay. Yeah, it's correct. So now we go on the next sum. The fourth sum. What temperature would be necessary to double the volume of a gas initially at STP if the pressure is decreased by 50%? What temperature would be necessary to double the volume of a gas initially at STP if the pressure is decreased by 50 degrees Celsius? Now they are asking the temperature, volume becomes double and pressure is decreased by 50%. So they have given volume, temperature, pressure. So you have to use the gas equation. Alright. So let's write down the particulars. So temperature T1, we'll take it as 273 Kelvin. The volume we take it as V. And the pressure P1 as P. Now they are asking the temperature. So T2 is equal to question mark. The volume becomes double, so V2 is equal to 2V and the pressure decreases by 50%, that means the pressure becomes half. So P2 is equal to P upon 2. So you want to use the formula P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon P2. Then you are going to substitute these values in this. So it comes to P into V upon 273 is equal to P upon 2 into 2V upon T2. So this 2 get cancelled. V and V get cancelled. P and P get cancelled. So we get therefore T2 as 273 Kelvin. Now if you want to get it in degree Celsius, 273 minus 273, that is 0 degree Celsius. So fifth sum. The gas cylinder having a capacity of 20 liters contains a gas at 100 atmosphere. How many flask of 200 centimeter cube capacity can be filled from it at 1 atmosphere pressure if the temperature remains constant? So over here they have given the volume as 20 liter. So 20 liter you can convert it into cc. 1 liter is 1000 cc. 20 liter will be 20,000 cc. So write down the particulars down first. Okay. So here they are saying they have given the volume 20 liter, that is 20,000 cc. Then they have given the pressure is 100 atmosphere, and the pressure on the other side is 1 atmosphere pressure, P2, and they have asked you to find out the volume. So now they have given the volume and pressure, temperature is constant, so obviously using the Boyle's law. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Substitute the values. 100 into 20,000 is equal to 1 into V2. Therefore, V2 will be 6 zeros cc. Now they have given something. They have given how many flask of 200 centimeter cube capacity can be filled. So one flask, the capacity is 200 centimeter cube, that is cc only. So 20, this is 2 followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros, 2, 3, 4, 5 centimeter cube, how many flask? This is 20 lakh divided by 200, that comes to 2 cancel, 10,000 flasks. Yeah. Sixth sum. A certain mass of a gas occupies 850 milliliter at a pressure of 760 millimeter of mercury. On increasing the pressure, it was found that the volume of the gas was 75% of its initial value. Find the pressure. Okay. So here we'll first write down whatever particulars they have given. Okay. So the volume is given 850 milliliter. Then pressure is given 760 millimeter, and the volume is 75%. Okay, 75% of 850. So V2 is equal to 75 upon 100 into 850. So it comes to 5. I'll just keep it like that only. We'll substitute and cancel it later on. Okay, and the pressure we need. So here the temperature is constant, so obviously using the Boyle's law. So P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So 760 into 850 is equal to P2 into 15 into 85 upon 2. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 129, 130, 131, 132, 133, 134 2 upon 15 into 85. So that comes to 1013.33 millimeter. And some, it is required to reduce the volume of a gas by 20% by compressing it at a constant pressure. To do so, the gas has to be cooled. If the gas attains a final temperature of 157 degrees Celsius, find the initial temperature. So we have to find out the initial temperature of the gas. Now, since they are speaking about volume and temperature, pressure is constant. Therefore, we are going to use the Charles law. So first of all, we'll write down all the details. So volume is V. V2 is 80%. Because 20% compressed, so 80% remain. So temperature T1 will take T. Temperature T2 they have given 157 plus 273, that comes to 430 Kelvin. Use the formula by Charles law. V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. Substitute V upon T is equal to 80 V upon 100 into 1 upon T2 is 430. V and V get cancelled. 0, 0 get cancelled. So T is coming to be 430 into 10 upon 8. So that is coming to 537. Now convert it into Kelvin. So 537.5 degree Celsius, we have to convert it to Kelvin. So you have to minus 273 from it. So that means the temperature will be 537.5 minus 273. It is coming to 264.5 degree Celsius. So Kelvin to degree Celsius, you have to subtract 273 from it. Now 8 sum. At a given temperature, the pressure of a gas reduces to 75% of its initial value. That means pressure becomes 75% less. And the volume increases by 40%. Volume increases by 40% of its initial value. Find this temperature if the initial temperature was minus 10 degrees Celsius. So now here the pressure is given, volume is given and temperature is given. So we are going to take the pressure P1 as P and the pressure on the other side is 75% of the initial value, that is 75 upon 100 P, and the volume they have said is becomes 40% of its initial value. So 40% of its initial value means 40% more. So it becomes 140. Okay. Like for example, if the volume is 100 and if it increases by 40%, so it becomes 140. So 40% of its initial value will be 140 upon 100 V. So V1 is V, V2 will be 140 V upon 100. Okay. So now temperature. T1 they have given minus 10. So minus 10 degree Celsius. You have to convert it into Kelvin plus 273. So it comes to 263 Kelvin. Okay. And the temperature on the other side we have to find out. So using the gas equation, P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. So P into V upon 263 is equal to 75 upon 100 P into 140 V upon 100 into 1 upon T. So here volume get cancelled, pressure get cancelled. So temperature will be 263 into 75 into 140 upon 100 into 100. So when you work it out, it comes to 276.15 Kelvin. That is equal to 276.15 minus 273, that is 3.15 degree Celsius. So that's how we solve the 8th sum. Now we go on another sum from the next exercise on the last page, page number 123. The first sum: what volume will a gas occupy at 740 millimeter pressure, which at 1480 occupies 500 cc? Temperature remains constant. Next question. Now we go on the sums on the next page, page number 124, last page of this chapter, and in that there are some numericals. We are going to solve them. So question number 3 ka first numerical: calculate the temperature of which to which a gas must be heated so that the volume triples without any change in pressure. The gas is originally at 57 degrees Celsius and having a volume of 150 cc. So quickly we'll write down all the particulars. They have said that the volume tripled. So if supposing we take the volume V1 as V, so V2 will be 3V. And the gas originally at 57 degrees Celsius. So T1 is 57 degrees Celsius, that is 57 plus 273, that is 330. Okay, and the temperature on the other side we have to find out. So here the pressure is constant, so we are going to use the Charles law. So V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. Write down this using Charles law and formula neatly, then only you will get full marks. And also check the values, the units and all, they should be proper. Therefore T2 will be 3 into 330, 990 Kelvin, that is 990 minus 273, that is 717 degrees Celsius. Okay, now we start with the second sum. A gas X at minus 33 degrees Celsius is heated to 127 degrees Celsius at a constant pressure. Calculate the percentage increase in the volume of the gas. So here they are asking about the volume, how much is the percentage increase. So how do you find out the percentage increase? The original volume and the final volume, you have to subtract both of them and divide by the original volume multiplied by 100, or in other words, increase volume upon original volume multiplied by 100. So first we'll write down all the particulars, then I will explain it to you. Okay. So second sum. The gas X at minus 33 degree Celsius. So temperature T1 is minus 33 degree Celsius. So add 273 to it. So it becomes 240 Kelvin. 2 then the temperature on the other side is 127. So T2 is 127 plus 273, that is coming to 400 Kelvin. The volume V1, they said the volume V1 we are taking as V. And on the other side, they are asking the volume. Okay, we have to find out the volume. And then later on, we can find out the percentage. So, here pressure is constant. So, using the Charles law. So, comes to like this, you can cancel it. Five V upon 3. So increase in volume. This is the original volume, this is the new volume. Increase will be subtract both of them. So 5V minus 3V, 2V upon 3. So percentage increase, 2V upon 3 divided by original volume multiplied by 100. So that is 2V upon 3 into 1 upon V into 100. So 200 upon 3, that is coming to 66, 2 by 3 percentage. Alright, now we go on the third sum. Calculate the volume of a gas A at STP if at 37 degree Celsius and 775 millimeter of mercury pressure, it occupies a volume of 9.5 liters. So over here, they have given the temperature, they have given the pressure, and they have given the volume. So you have to use the gas equation. So we write down the particulars first. So the temperature is 37. So 37 degree Celsius plus 273, that is 310 Kelvin. And on the other side, the temperature is 273 Kelvin. Okay. Pressure P1 is 775 millimeter and P2 is 760 millimeter. Okay, then volume V1 is 9.5, that is 19/2 liters, and here V2 we have to find out. Now remember, on the other side, they have not given temperature and pressure. So temperature you have to take 273 Kelvin and pressure you have to take 760 millimeter. Then using the gas equation. P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Substitute the values. So 775 into 19/2 upon T1, that is 310, is equal to P2 V2 upon T2 is 273. So send everything on the other side. Solve this, cancel whatever, and volume is coming to 8.53 liters. Alright. Now we go on the fourth sum. Calculate the temperature at which a gas A at 20 degrees Celsius having a volume of 500 cc will occupy a volume of 250 cc. So here temperature and volume is being spoken about. Pressure is not given. So obviously it's going to be Charles' law. So use the formula for Charles' law. First you take down the particulars and then we'll solve it. Okay. So temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. So 20 plus 273. That is 293 Kelvin. And that side the temperature is to be found out. Volume is given as 500 cc. And that side volume is 250 cc. So using the Charles' law. V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. So 293 upon 500 is equal to 250 upon T2. Therefore T2 is equal to 250 into 500 upon 293. So when you work it out, it comes to 146.5 Kelvin. That is 146.5 minus 273. That comes to minus 126 degree Celsius. Alright. Now the fifth sum. A gas X is collected over water at 17 degree Celsius and 750 millimeter pressure. If the volume of the gas collected is 50 cc, calculate the volume of dry gas at STP. 17 degree Celsius, the vapor pressure is 14 millimeter. So at 17 degrees, the pressure is 14 millimeter. This thing what they have written is very, very important. So 14 degrees is the pressure when the temperature is 17 degrees. So how much is the increase in the pressure? That pressure you have to take. So when you are writing the particular, you have to subtract 14 from the 746. Okay, so we'll take it down first. Take down the particulars first. Okay, so the temperature T1 is 17 degrees Celsius. Convert it into Kelvin. 17 plus 273. That is 290 Kelvin. And on the other side, temperature you have to take 273 Kelvin. Then pressure P1. The pressure P1 is given as 750. From that, you have to minus 14 because that was the initial pressure. And then later on, it becomes 750. So total pressure, how much has it increased? For that, you have to subtract it. So 750 minus 14. That is 736. Millimeters. So that is the pressure considered. Okay. So whatever is the pressure minus the initial pressure. Remember that last sentence which they have given the question, that has to be kept in mind. Whenever such sentence comes, remember to subtract that number. Okay. And volume is 50 cc. On the other side, the pressure is 760 millimeter and volume you have to find out. So using the gas equation, P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Then substitute the values. P1 is 736 into V1 is 50 upon T1 is 290 is equal to P2 760 into V2 to be found out upon T2, that is 273. So find out V2, send everything on the other side. 736 into 50 into 273 upon 290 into 760. Work it out, it comes to 45.58 cc. Alright. So that's how we do the fifth sum. Start with the next question. The questions are from page number 124. Question number 4. First question. Subpart first. The pressure of a gas having volume 1000 cc originally occupying 1500 cc at 720 millimeter pressure. So you have to find out the pressure of the gas. Okay, they have given the volume. So if pressure and volume is given, temperature is constant, so we make use of the Boyle's law. Okay, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So first we'll write down all the particulars and then we will solve it. Okay. Pressure we have to find. Volume is 1000 cc. Pressure on the other side, they have given 720 millimeter. Volume 1500 cc. So using Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 into 1000 is equal to 720 into 1500. So P1 is equal to 720 into 1500 upon 1000. So it comes to 1080 millimeter. Okay. So now we go on the second sum. The pressure of a gas having 100 liters originally occupying 75 dm cube at 700 millimeter pressure. So over here also they are speaking about a volume and pressure. Okay, temperature is constant, so we are making use of a Boyle's law. Okay, write down all the particulars. So we have to find out the pressure of a gas having 100 liters. V1 question mark. V1 100 liters originally occupying 75 dm cube at 700 millimeter pressure. So P2 700 millimeter, volume 75 dm cube. So using Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Substitute the values. It comes to 525 millimeter. Okay. Now the third sum. The pressure of a gas having volume 380 liters originally occupying 800 cc at 76 centimeter of pressure. Okay, so they have given the volume to be 380 liters and originally occupying 800 cc, that is the pressure, at 76 centimeter of pressure. So we write down the particulars first. So volume is 380 liters and originally occupying 800 cc. Now see, here it is liters, here it is cc. How do you convert liter into cc? 1 liter is 1000 cc. So 380 into 1000 cc. Okay. And the pressure over here is to be found out. Pressure on the other side is 76 centimeter. So the temperature is constant. Use the Boyle's law. So it comes to 0.16 centimeter of mercury. So that's your third sum. Now fourth sum. The pressure of a gas having volume 1800 milliliter originally occupying 300 milliliter at 6 atmospheric pressure. So they are asking a pressure when volume 1800 occupies 300 milliliter at 6 atmospheric pressure. So again here also you are using the Boyle's law. Okay, we write down the particulars down. So using volume is 300 milliliters. So it is 1 atmospheric pressure. Now we go on the fifth sum. Alright. Please work them all out in your notebook. The pressure of a gas having volume 1500 cc originally occupying 750 cc at 5 atmospheric pressure. So volume is 1500 cc V1. And pressure they are asking, and on the other side volume 750 cc at 5 atmosphere pressure. So again temperature is constant using the Boyle's law. Atmospheric pressure. Alright. So now question number 5, subpart first. Okay. Question number 5. This was question number 4. Question number 5. First subpart. The temperature at which 500 cc of a gas at X the temperature at which 500 cc of gas X at temperature 293 Kelvin occupies half its original volume, pressure is constant. So over here we are going to use the Charles law. So we fill in all the details first. So the volume is 500 cc. Now the volume becomes half. So 250 cc. Okay, the temperature they are given 293 Kelvin. And they have given it in Kelvin, that's why we don't have to minus 273. Using Charles law, V1 is equal to P2. No, sorry. V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. So 500 upon 293 is equal to 250 upon T2. Therefore T2 is equal to 250 into 293 upon 500. So 293 upon 2, that is equal to 146.5 Kelvin. Right. If you want it in degree Celsius, minus 273 from it. Okay. Now we start with the second sum. The volume of STP occupied by gas Y, originally occupying 760 cc at 300 Kelvin and 70 centimeter pressure of mercury. So they are asking the volume at STP. Okay. So gas Y originally occupying 760 cc at 300 Kelvin. So the volume and temperature on the left hand side, you can take it as V1 as 760 cc, temperature as 300 Kelvin, and pressure is given as 70 centimeter. And on the other side, volume is to be found out, pressure is 76 centimeter, and temperature is 273 Kelvin. Okay, whenever temperature is not given, you have to take 273. Okay, now since volume, temperature, pressure is given using gas equation formula, V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Substitute the values. Okay. And when you solve it, it comes to 637 cc. Alright. So this is your second sum. Now third sum. Okay, third sum. The volume at STP occupied by a gas Z, originally occupying 1.57 decimeter cube at 310.5 Kelvin and 75 centimeter pressure of mercury. So according to whatever details they have given in the question, write down all the particulars. So the volume they have given is 1.57 dm cube. Pressure 75 centimeter, temperature 310.5 Kelvin, and on the other side, volume you have to find out. Pressure, if you see the pressure, what they have given is 75 centimeter, but we have got 760 millimeter. So you have to convert it into centimeter. See, the pressure is 75 centimeter given. We always take the pressure as 760 millimeter. 760 millimeter has to be converted into centimeter, because here it is centimeter, here also it should be 70 centimeter. So that's why write 76 centimeter over here. And temperature 273, right? Now use the formula. P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Substitute the values. So then V2 comes to 1.36 dm cube. Right? Now question number 4. the volume at STP occupied. So you have to find out the volume. The volume at STP occupied by a gas Q originally occupying 153.7 centimeter cube at 287 Kelvin and 750 millimeter pressure. Vapor pressure of a gas Q at 287 Kelvin is 12 millimeter of mercury. So here in bracket again they have given that the pressure is 12 millimeter when the temperature is 287. So you have to minus this 12 millimeter from the pressure which they have given in the question. So the pressure that they have given is 750 millimeter. So 750 minus 12 you are going to do. Just see what I am doing. Okay, keep a note of all this. So the volume is 153.7 centimeter cube. Temperature is 287 Kelvin. And the pressure 750 minus 12, that is 738 millimeter. Okay, and on that side the volume we have to find out. The temperature is 273 Kelvin and the pressure is 760 millimeter. Okay, see millimeter millimeter, so it's same. So using gas equation, P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. So substitute the value. So V2 is equal to 141.707 centimeter cube. Alright. Now fifth sum. The temperature to which a gas P has to be heated to triple its volume. Okay, volume becomes tripled. If the gas originally occupies 150 centimeter cube at 330 Kelvin, pressure remaining constant. So pressure remaining constant, we are going to use Charles' law. Okay. So just see how I do it. V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. So V1 is V upon 330 is equal to PV upon T2. This V and V get cancelled. Therefore T2 is equal to 3 into 330. That is 990 Kelvin. That is equal to, if you minus 273 from it, if you minus 273 you get it to degree Celsius, but I'm keeping it as it is unless and until they ask in the school exam that they wanted it degree Celsius. So if they wanted it degree Celsius, subtract minus 273 from this, subtract 273 from this. All right 92 ka board question. A fixed volume of a gas occupies 760 centimeter cube at 27 degree Celsius and 70 centimeter of mercury. What would be its volume at STP? So they have given the volume, that is 760 centimeter cube, temperature 27, that is to be converted into Kelvin, adding to 273, and pressure is 70, and volume they have asked. Now as usual on the other side, the temperature and pressure, temperature you have to take 273 Kelvin and pressure 760 millimeter. Alright, substitute using the formula gas equation ka, P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Please try it. Now here it is 760 millimeter and here it is 70 centimeter. Unit should be same. So I am taking 76 centimeter. Okay. Using the gas equation. So when you work it out, it comes to 637 centimeter cube. Alright, next question. 1995 question. At 0 degree Celsius and 760 millimeter mercury pressure, the gas occupies a volume of 100 centimeter cube. The temperature of the gas is increased by 1/5. Okay, the temperature is increased by 1/5, while the pressure is increased 1.5 times. So the pressure becomes 1.5 times. Calculate the final volume. Again, I'll repeat. At 0 degree Celsius and 760 millimeter mercury pressure, a gas occupies a volume of 100 centimeter cube. The temperature of the gas is increased by 1/5. Temperature is increased by 1/5. That means the temperature becomes 1/5 times more than what it was before, while the pressure is increased 1.5 times. So calculate the final temperature, right? So over here we write down all the particulars down. P1 is 760. Volume is 100 centimeter cube. Temperature I am taking as T, and pressure they are saying the pressure is increased 1.5 times. So 1.5 times means 3/2. Okay, and the volume you have to find out. And temperature is increased 1.5 times, T plus 1/2 T, that is 1/5 times. So here it is 1/5. So LCM 5T plus 1T is, that is 6T/5. Okay. Then use the gas equation formula. P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Substitute the values. So substitute all the values. You get P into 100 upon T is equal to dP upon 2 into V2 upon 60/5. So here this T and T get cancelled, P and P get cancelled. 100 is equal to 3V2 into 5 upon 2 into 6. Send everything on the other side except for V2. So 80 cc. Now we continue with another board question which had come in the year 1996, a board question. Okay, the pressure on 1 mole of a gas at STP is double and the temperature is raised to 546 Kelvin. What is the final volume of the gas? 1 mole of a gas occupies a volume of 22.4 liters at STP. Okay, so we write down all the particulars down. The pressure is P millimeter and there that side pressure is 2P because the pressure becomes double if you read the question again. T1 is 273 Kelvin, T2 is 546. That is the pressure becomes double. Okay, the pressure of 1 mole of a gas at STP is doubled and the temperature is raised to 546 Kelvin. Okay. Then what is the final volume? V1 is 22.4, they are given 22.4, so take that liters, and here V2 we have to find out. So using the gas equation, P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. Substitute the values. This P and P get cancelled. So when you work it out, the volume comes to 22.4 liters. The sums of gas laws, please solve them again. If you have any doubts, please ask in the comment section. If you want any videos of such type of any of the lesson, please let me know. If you have understood this explanation, please like and share this video and also subscribe. Thank you very much. See you. Bye bye.